Now we'll talk about the SIP microoperation. So for serial transfer we may use SIP microoperations. So three basic types of SIP microoperations are there: logical shift, circular shift, and arithmetic shift. Okay, so there are three basic microoperations: logical shift, circular shift, and arithmetic shift. Now we can use the symbol like this. So shift left. For shift left, simple shift left, we use R1, shift left R1. For shift right R1, shift right R1. This is what simple shift. Then for circular shift, we can use R1, circular left, left for left shift, circular left shift. And for circular right shift, we can use R1, CIR, R1. And for arithmetic, for left, we use R1, ASHL, R1. And for the right shift, ASHR, R1. Okay. So, for logical shift, we can use SHL, R1. For logical shift left right, we can use SHR R1. For circular shift is CIL R1. For R1 is the register. Similarly, for right operation, right shift, circular shift, we can use CIR R1. For arithmetic shift, ASHL R1. And for arithmetic right, ASHL R1. Okay. Now we just see the difference of all the shift operations one by one. So first one is logical shift. Okay, a logical shift is one that transfers 0 through the serial input. So logical shift, suppose R1, SHL R1, okay, SLH R1, suppose it is 0 1 1 0. Now shift left means what? Shifting left here. So this one will here, this one will here, this 0 will here, this 0 will be discarded. This 0 will be discarded, and where you have to insert 0. We can take another example. Suppose 1, 0, 1, 1. And we have to apply shift left. So this 0 will shift here. This 1 will shift here. This 1 will shift here. Here we have to insert a 0. Okay. And this 1 will be discarded. Okay. So we can take a blocks. Blockwise we can implement. Say 1, 0, 1, 1, and after that operation, this 0 will shift here, this 1 will be here, this 1 will be here. Here we have to insert 0, okay, and this 1 will be discarded. So this is shift left. Similarly, shift right, okay, suppose it is 1, 0, 1, 1, and we have applied, this is R1 register, SHR R1, then what will happen? This one will transfer here, this 0 will transfer here, this one will transfer here, where you have to insert 0, and this one will be discarded. Similarly, suppose the content of R1, say 1 0 0 0, then what will happen? We have to apply the shift right operation. So this one will shift here, this 0 will shift here, this 0 will shift here, this 0 will be discarded, and here you have to insert 0. Okay, so this is what logical shift. This is shift left, this is shift right. Now second is what? It is circular shift. Now circular shift, suppose the content of the R1 register, say 1 0 1 1, and we have to apply shift left, circular shift left. That means this one. So what will happen here? So shift left means this 0 will shift here, this 1 will shift here, this 1 will shift here, and this 1 will shift there. That means this 1 will shift here. Okay, so circular. So circular means what? We can say like this way. Okay, similarly, we can take another example. Suppose it is 0, 1, 0, 1. And circular shift left, then what will happen? This, so we have to apply this particular, so circular shift, so one, this one will shift here, this zero will shift here, this one will shift here, okay, and this one will shift there. So that means here we have to set zero. Similarly, circular shift right. So for circular shift right, here suppose 1 0 1 1, okay, and we have to apply circular shift right, then what will happen? Shift right, that means this one will shift here, this zero will shift here, this one will shift here, and this one will shift there. That means output will be this one. Similarly, if it is 0, 1, 1, 0, and we want to apply CIR R1 and transfer to R1, so what will happen? Circular shift right. Circular shift right means what? This 0 will shift here, this 1 will shift here, this 1 will shift here, this 0 will shift here. That means your output will be this one. Okay, so this is the nothing but our rotate operation. Now we can see arithmetic shift. Now in arithmetic shift is a micro operation that shift a signed binary number to the left and right. Okay, so if it is shifting left means what? Multiplies a signed number by 2, and shifting right means what? Divide the number by 2. And arithmetic shift must leave the sign bit unchanged. The sign of the number remains the same when it is multiplied or divided by 2. So first of all, we just see shift right operation. First of all, we just see arithmetic shift right. Arithmetic shift right operation. And we just see the register figure. So this is say R0, R1, R2. If it is say Rn-1, so while shifting we have to copy the bit here. So this is arithmetic shift right. So arithmetic shift right of the register say R1, for example. Suppose already you know, suppose if it is plus 10, so we use 0 for positive number and we use 1 for negative number. So if it is 0, so 0, 10, 10 means what? If it is 10 means what? 1, 0, 1, 0. And if it is, assume it is 8-bit number, so 8-bit number means how you can store 10 in 8-bit number, 8-bit register. Say 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. Forget about this one. Say 0 bit, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Forget about this also. And the remaining 0, 0, 0. And we want to apply the shift right, means we have to shift this one. Then what will happen? We can just see. Here we have to discard, here we have to transfer 1, 1, here to transfer 0, here to transfer 1, and where to 0, here 0, 0, 0, 0, that's 0, and here we have to copy the same content, here we have to copy the same thing, so we have to copy the same thing, 0. Now here 1, 0, 1, 0, this is plus 10, and here the output is 1, 0, 1, this is plus 5. That means what? Shifting right means what? Divide the number by 2. Divide the number by 2 means 10 by 2 is nothing but our 5. Okay, so it is integer division. Suppose a number is say, we can say, we can take another example. Suppose plus 9. Okay, so 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1. And if you apply shift operation, shift right operation, the what will be the output? So this 0 will be here, this 0 will be here, this 1 will be here, and register 0. So this is nothing but our plus 4. So 9 by 2 in integer division, output will be what? 4. So this is the 4. Okay. Now if it is minus 10, then what will happen? And we want to apply the shift right operation. So 10 means what? Just first of all, you just see the register, draw the figure, register figure. Suppose plus 10. Plus 10 is what? 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. This is plus 10. And what is minus 10? What is minus 10? So we have to apply 2's complement of that. So 2's complement is what? 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1. This is what? 2's complement, this is what? Minus 10 in 2's complement form. Okay. Now 10 minus 10 divided by 2, that will be the answer will be minus 5. So 10 will be stored like this way, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0. And if you apply shift right, so then what will happen? This one will shift here, this one will shift here, this 0 will shift here, this remaining are the 1, 1, 1. And we have to copy the 1. This is the output. The output will be what? 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. The question is it 5? So once again, we have to apply the 2's complement. So 1, 0, 1. 0, 0, 0. Okay, so this is nothing but our 5. So this is nothing but 2's complement of the minus 5. Okay. Now, arithmetic shift left. Now see the left part. Okay, now we have to check whether overflow is there or not. Suppose a register shift. So next is what? Arithmetic shift left. Arithmetic shift left. So in arithmetic shift left, suppose the register is like this way. So this is say Rn minus 1, this is Rn. Okay, this is 0 bit, 0 or 0 bit or 1 bit. And we have to check whether the overflowed or not. So Rn minus 1 XOR Rn. And if it is 0, then no overflow. No overflow. And if it is 1, overflow is there. Okay, so we can check. Suppose a number is, first of all, see the register. Zero, one, two, three, four, five, six, and seven. Suppose the number is plus 10. Okay, so plus 10 means output will be 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. This is plus 10, so we have to store this one 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. And we have to, and we have applied arithmetic shift left of the R1 register. Say, as if this is R1 register. Then what will happen? You can see here, so this 0 will shift here, this 1 will shift here, okay, this 0 will shift here, similarly this 1 will shift here, 0, 0, and for this VS, this 1, this 0 will shift here. Now we have to check, next we have to check the VS. So this is what? Vn minus 1, this is Vn minus 2. So 0 XOR 0, this is 0. So XOR truth table already we know. This is 0, 1, 1, 0. This is what? XOR truth table. So this is A base it. So 0 means what is not overflow. And here, here, here you have to insert 0 here. your pins are 0, and the output will be what? 0 0 0 1 0 1 0 0. This is nothing but plus 20. Okay, and we can check also, suppose minus 10, what is the 2's complement of minus 10? It is representation of the minus 10, so in 2's complement form, so it is what? 0 1 1 0 rest are 1. Okay, now if we beat, we apply shift left operation, then we can see here 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 and we have to store data 1 1 1 1 0 1 1 0, and if we apply the shift left operation, so same register, just take the same register, so this 0 will shift here, this 1 will shift here, this 1 will shift here, 0 1 1 and here this 2 and here this 1 will shift here. And we have to check the BS, so this 1 1 XOR 1 1 1 output is 0, that means it is not overflowed, and here we have to insert 0. Clear? So it is in 2's complement form. If you apply once again 2's complement, then what will happen? So it is a negative number because here we have stored minus 10. Okay, this is minus 10. So what will happen? 0 0 1 1 0 1 1 1, and if you apply 2's complement of that, it will be 0 0 1 0 1 0 0 0. So you can see these two, both are same, that is, this is nothing but our 20. And definitely here negative value of 20 is there, so here answer minus 20 is in 2's complement form. Okay, and that is it of this video. Thank you very much.